And I was just about to get out of Grass Town. That blows. I don't think that's how it works, Devour. So YouTube has no obligation to prosecute a false flagger on your behalf. That's something that you have to do. Which I think is kind of the thesis of what I'm saying with the automated takedown stuff that's also being implemented with Twitch. Is that they're just kind of, you know, they're siding with the idea that, you know, people on the internet are a bunch of fuckers and they're just gonna pirate things anyway, so if we take things down and play it safe, that's fine, because then we won't get sued by a company that has money to make us pay for hosting their material. But when it comes to, you know, like some small channel, well, who cares? You know, it's never... It's never going to come to that. It's not going to cost them anything if they pull down one of Captain Clever's videos or one of my videos or any of those kinds of things. It's not something they will ever have to worry about because, hey, shitting on the little guy, it's an American tradition. Well, not just American. Yeah. Unhistoric tradition. Absolutely. Yeah, I agree that it would be a lot of work, Devour. Who wants to do work to make sure that the product you're offering works properly and isn't breaking laws and doing all that stuff? Nobody wants to do that work. Which is why we get shoddy automated systems that will do it for you. At a fraction of the price. And just as good! I'm sure. I would agree that that would, in fact, show a little class. But showing or having cannot make your bottom line any better. And remember that YouTube and Google are businesses. One and the same, actually. For all relevant purposes, I think. And that... Again, like, the whole idea of pissing on the little guy, like, that's not something that's going to make them money. So if your channel gets blocked, generally speaking, you know, if a larger channel gets, you know, pooped on or whatever, yeah, you know, like, that channel probably makes YouTube a whole lot of money, and they are going to have some sort of vested interest in looking out for them. But somebody like, you know, yourself, myself, YouTube... doesn't really care. We're probably costing them more money than they're making off of us. in terms of what they have to host for us, you know, how many dollars per gigabyte, all that kind of jazz. Whereas larger corporations and stuff like that, where copyright may be an issue, that's absolutely something that they have to watch out for, because that is a substantial potential loss of money. So they're going to be looking after their bottom line, which is understand company. That's basically their only interest. But still pretty shitty. Yeah, that's also true, Kem. And it's the same thing that I found. It was something really funny on this response that Twitch gave to Hitbox. Or no, it was a pastebin I read from Adam AK. He runs a lot of like GTA games. What? And that kind of thing. And, you know, he was saying, it's like, hey, I checked out Hitbox, it's sort of like a smaller version of Twitch when they just started out, but, you know, oh, they don't have the capacity for this, and they don't have the capacity for this, and they can't do this. And it's kind of funny, it's sort of like, okay, so you just said that they are a version of what Twitch was like, but they can't do any of these things that Twitch is now doing? Sure. And I agree, they're not doing those things now. That is an incontrovertible fact, but to say that, you know, they have no capability to do that stuff is just kind of really goofy. Sort of like saying, when I first played Cave Story, I have no capability to get through sacred grounds alive. Which was true at the time. But now? Things change. But yeah. Yeah, they do want to keep the smaller broadcasters around, because everyone starts off, generally, everyone starts off in that kind of position and then gets bigger, rather than is already a smash hit when they start up. So I think they do have a vested interest in that, but at the same time, there are always going to be a lot of people that are small and will always stay small. Or people who, you know, get to a certain sort of cap or limit and then don't wind up with much more than they're carving out. You know, totally depending on what they're putting into it and all that kind of stuff. I mean, I'm almost certainly never going to make it to those levels, or like very high levels of popularity, because one, this is more of a hobby thing for me. I'm really not treating it like a job. My interests are far more academic as it comes to, you know, earning money and doing all that kind of stuff. So at some point in time, I will wind up spending lots more time dedicating to other elements of my life rather than streaming, which means that I am going to fall behind those who have the time and effort to really gun for that kind of stuff, which is not something I'm, you know, complaining about or bitter about. It's just a recognition of things as they are. Bats. Now that I can blame on RNG and bad AI. They were just being annoying. Huh. I don't think I've ever received invitations to join any kinds of groups. Please. On YouTube or Twitch or anything like that. I'm also not sure I quite understand the reasoning behind it. I mean, I know people love to form groups about all kinds of things, but I don't quite understand all of the stuff that goes into it. Like, I know there's those Twitch groups, like, you know, so-and-so is streaming on, you know, Speed Demos Archive, or Speedruns Live, or Hike White, which is the apparently cutest speedrunning group that you can find on Twitch. I mean, I guess, like, do people look at those and, like, look for streamers that are a part of those groups? Okay, this is a problem. I want all that. I'm stopping to get it, and I don't care that it's slow. My health is kind of low here, though. So that's what I'm supposed to do, and then... What?! Come on! That hitbox, dude! What the hell was that? I'll tell you what that was. Bullshit. Fuck you, frog. Why is he jumping there all of a sudden? Something it's never done before. Ugh, more time down the drain. Do I only have 3 health? Balrog could totally kill me here. Booty, congratulations on your new record. Everybody in chat, Booty Biscuit runs. Actually, put a lot of work into the Hell Temple speedrun for La Milana. And runs Descent in varying shapes, sizes, and categories. Check him out. Whoa! Alright, I'm fine. Descent is one of those games that is, I think some people would probably find difficulty watching it, because it is... Wow, these missile drops are so amazing. Because disorienting is hell, for a lot of people, but I really enjoy the game. I really enjoyed playing it casually, and watching speedruns of it is really cool. You're looking to running that in a year, Captain Clever? It seems oddly specific. Why a year? Ow. What the hell was that? He cheated. You see that? Balrog, a cheater, confirmed. Oh, okay, I can survive this hit, so I'm going for it. Oh, I missed. Don't have level 3 Polar Star, but I'm very close to having it, so that's cool. Hearts. How am I doing on this? Okay, I need more experience on my missile launcher in a big way. What do you play with, Spooty? Do you play with a like keyboard, mouse, joystick? For descent? I'm kinda curious. I am very much so looking forward to some games that are going to bring back me playing with a joystick. I have a decent joystick, I just don't have that many games that it's really appropriate for using. Looking forward to Star Citizen and Chris Roberts' project. Alright, that's good. I'm fine with this. I just have to not die, like, you know, on these spikes. Ow! Jerk! What the hell is that? Bats. Swing and a miss! One of the other record controllers plays on a 360 controller. Interesting. Never played a joystick controller. I think I remember playing Descent with a joystick when it came out. But there were a lot more of those, a lot more joystick, either dependent or, you know, best played with games at the time. X-Wing, TIE Fighter, Wing Commander, all sorts of, like, World War II flight sims, ASIC. It was a golden era. It continued for a while, too. You know, we had X-Wing versus TIE Fighter, Free Space, Free Space 2. I didn't play Free Space 2 and Free Space until, actually, a couple of years ago, when I picked it up from Good Old Games so that I could play the Battlestar Galactica Total Conversion Diaspora Shattered Armistice, which was fucking awesome. And honestly, not just if you're a fan of Battlestar Galactica, like, just as a flight game, it was a whole lot of fun. No, Curly, I'm not here to murder the bunny people. Give me your machine gun. Give me your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle. I think Quote would look pretty sweet in that pink tank top. didn't think I was supposed to destroy those ones. Whoops. Oh well. It's reality now. Just gotta deal with it. Oh god. Wow, that was almost an absolute fucking catastrophe. Four missiles should be enough. Interesting. That mistake I made sort of helped. Sweet, well, Sand Zone is going pretty well so far. Made it to Curling in good order. Had a good fight at Curling. Getting to Omega was quite good. The Omega fight was fine. Getting away from Omega was quite good. Let's keep this up. Just need to get a few rumps for my machine gear, and we will be rosy. That's pretty good. Frankie. Not happy about taking that damage or losing level 3 fireball, but worse things have happened. And it's not that far away from level 3 anyways, so. See, I've already got level 3 again. Yay. And I didn't really waste any time getting it, so now I just have to focus on my missile launcher. Whoa. What was I thinking? It's too low to take a hit on here. Hopefully I can just get away without getting hit by these birds. Otherwise I'll have to take it on my... Yeah. I have to take it on my machine gun. Unfortunate because I still have to go back. Screw you! Okay. I have to be cautious about my low health here. Thank you. Biker Z. Okay, I still need level 3 missile launcher. So I am going to kill these guys for their drops. And now I think ideally at this point I would not. Because they're going to be respawned when I come back this way anyway. Of course, my health is a little bit better here because I got that health upgrade. It's kind of nice that those give you not just an upgrade, but also, you know, it's not just max. They give you the health that they would, you know, appropriately upgrade. So if you're a little bit low, like I am right now, it's kind of nice. Alright, I still have a couple of places where I can pick up some drops. How am I for actual ammo? Okay, I'm fine. Good. Alright. I would like to have more health than I currently have. But I don't think I need it. I don't think I need it for the Toroko boss fight. If I get damaged here by these birds, I'm going to be very unhappy. Because I don't have a lot of... here, let's see. Can I get... this. I am gonna heal up. The cockroaches after this point are jerks. And they do a lot of damage on contact. It's like 5 per. And they're kind of hard to predict. So. I'm gonna lose probably 3 or 4 seconds because I stopped for the health and to get my fireball back at level 3. You said you lose level 3. You know, machine gun. Hopefully I still won't. Oh, I completely missed Toroko with that missile barrage. It's fine. It's gonna be more than 3 or 4 seconds. Still, 20 seconds ahead here is pretty good. Wonder if I'll get Poo-Black once. About to find out. Okay, I'm continuing to complain about my mashing speed and skill, but I have definitively improved. Like, there's really no doubt about it. I am better. Much better than when I started. So, I'm gonna have to find something else to complain about. Like these guys. Fucking cockroaches. Oh. I bury these cockroaches. Hey, I'm one. Eh, no worries, I know that feeling. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. Oh, no. That was bad. This is going to be slow. I missed a cycle here. One hit. It was one hit, man. Come on, get over there. So I'm probably losing time here. I'm almost definitively losing time here. Ow! I look over at chat and there's like a freaking missile right up my ass. Okay. So, today I learned my Monster X split is bad. Always complain about cockroaches. Curly seems to have recovered from her very short bout of depression. Sweet! First time I killed Balrog before he hit the ground. Hey, Drac. Thank you. Speaking of which, I am about to be right there. Open the box. Where's my experience for my... Okay. I might be able to take a hit on this thing. Ow. Ow. I actually appreciate those heart drops in some way, shape, or form. I might want to grab a tiny amount of experience more on my missile launcher. Just like so. Okay. Good to go here. Excellent. I stopped a little bit to get that extra, those extra goodies, but otherwise I think my execution through here is... eminently acceptable. Why do I think that Curly has dialogue when I come in here? That's why I'm like jumping and hitting my head on that like little arrow above the door. Let's see if I can get the first water skip. I struggle with this sometimes. I got it. I never really figured out the timing on it that well, but... most of the time. I have 8 rockets, so this should be fine. Hopefully I get some good drops. I've never been in this position. I'm not sure I should be drowning myself this much. Oh well, I'm not kidding anyways. Damn, I'm at 100 frickin' drowning thing, but I killed the core really fast. So, I think this will be a good split. Because technically speaking, the only reason why my fluids are lower when I kill the core is because I'm killing the core later in the fight, which doesn't seem like it's, you know, in any way faster. Yeah, fucking slick. That was a good fight. I got lucky with some of those missile drops though, man. Like, he just dumped, like, what, 3 right in front of his face? The satellites were in excellent positions as well, because I was hitting him with a lot of the machine gun. And then it, like, on the first phase, it just opened itself right up, and I was able to just hammer through blade damage. Big time. So, I think... You know, I got lucky in that fight in terms of what I was given, but I absolutely think that my execution was like up to it. It wasn't a case of it's like, oh, I lucked out. It was a case of, cool, I got good luck, and I executed really well on that luck. My practice on the core fight definitely seems to have paid off a lot. It's been pretty consistently good. Since I practiced. Go figure. Practice makes you better at things. I should be an educator. No, get in there. Oh wow. I guess it's that time of day, man. Is it 4:20? The people in apartments living below mine apparently think it is. Do I even need missiles right now? I don't think I use missiles until, like, I'm fighting, I don't know, the doctor or something. It's kind of bad. Oh, he almost got away from me. That would have been my fault, because I totally whiffed on my first blade in that fight. Up. Oh. Oh, that thing only does one damage? Jeez, I've been avoiding it like the plague. Sick machine, or sick boost. Yeah, we're doing it. Thanks, someone. Yeah, I haven't really started incorporating, like, everything. Oops. Everything in there in terms of, like, all the different tricks that I could be doing, but whatever, man. The stuff that I went for, I did well, so. I got it. Oops. Oh, cool. I've got max machine gun experience here. That's kind of nice. Any hits during the fight with Mopignon. Okay, never mind. Just take damage from AP for fun. Keep screwing up that. It's a bit weird. Damn it, I didn't skip that text box. Look at this guy. Like, he's in prison. He's got, like, this huge smile on his face. He's just, like, pigging out in the corner. It's like, oh yeah, by the way, all my friends are in danger. I'm just gonna sit here and eat. Man, this is good. Oh. Like, oh. This food. Oh, it's... damn. This isn't the fastest machine boost I've ever done, but it's still pretty quick. Quick enough for me to want to use it. Yes. No. Hooray, I'm in the Mushroom Club. I've got my, like, little badge and everything. It's cute. Mukaupon, thank you. Let's see if I get the fish boost. Kind of? I didn't get it in the way that I wanted to get it, but I boosted off of... So... sure, we'll go with that. All else being equal, this will maybe be another gold split, or I might be saving time here anyways. Well, no, all else being equal, this will be a gold also, because I don't think I've ever gotten the fish boost in a run. Or while my timer was going anyways. I love the nature of that request. Please move while I'm, like, shooting him incessantly in the back with the fireball. Why are these peas so aggressive anyways? I mean, I understand, like, the giant, like, dudes. Like, they just stand around. And then if you shoot them, they attack you. That makes sense. And they're just kind of looking after the Mimi Guzz, making sure that they're working and doing all that kind of jazz. And it's like, alright, this enemy makes sense to me. But the peas? Like, they just have this ridiculous expression on their face. They run around like frickin' little madmen. Alright, coming right up to my clutch choke point of the game. Is Final Cave the right place for you to choke? Talk to your doctor. He went the wrong way, but he died really fast. I'm not sure how to feel about that. Fuck you, Final Cave. Hello, Acmatica. Excuse me? It's happening again. Never get onto this platform. It's so funny. I mean, it's a very amusing way to lose time, but jeez, dude. It's like a fucking slapstick comedy routine right at the run. I can't enter a door. Misery. too? I swear. Not today. Not today, Sue. Jesus, dude, they're trying to kill me. That tile room was atrocious. Down there. Damn. Do this fight. Gosh. I gotta pop now. I could have survived. With one health. He's a little far in this direction. Damn, 10 health. That hurts, man. Well, that feels like redemption. Lost a little bit of time on the doctor, lost a little bit of time on the ended core. But I crushed the end game with a fucking vengeance. That tile room, though, man. I mean, am I wrong? That seemed like a really bad pattern. Thanks, everybody. That was cool. That was a lot of fun. There we go. I'll agree with that, M1. Every tile room pattern is bad. Yeah, I think that's the first time I've gotten the quick kill on Balas. Like, normally I miss one or two of the satellites. Whoa, that's weird, Devour. How did you know I had toast popping out of my head? Are you psychic? Or have remote viewing abilities? I'm a little bit interested in what my sum of best is at this point in time. I'll take a look at it after the credits roll. But I'm kind of getting into that zone where I'm like, I mean, that was a really good run. I didn't lose time on very many segments. Let's see, I lost time on Balrog. And then let's see, Balfrog, Curly, Omega, Dogs. Yeah, and then I lost a little bit of time on Balrog, I lost a little bit of time on the Taroko split, and then I lost time on Doctor and Undead Core, but everywhere else I was ahead. And a lot of gold, too. Not all of them were big, but that one in hell, 10 seconds, that's nice. Nice to come up with 10 seconds somewhere. Yeah, I'll have to rewatch the run and then take a look at my times and stuff like that and see if it's something that I want to continue to improve or if this is like a ton that I'm happy with. Like I don't think I'm going to get into like that top tier echelon of like sub 1 hour. But maybe, I don't know. I'll have to take a look. Think about it. I mean, there's other things that I want to put time into as well. Like, I have been running Kero Blaster, but I haven't really been practicing it or, like, really putting time into it, whereas I've really been putting time into Cave Story. I've been practicing, definitely getting better at stuff in Cave Story. So I do kind of want to put some time into practicing that, and, you know, like, there's other projects and things that I want to work on as well, so I'll have to see if it's something where it's like, yeah, no, I could totally improve on that. But for the most part, I felt pretty good about that run. Yeah, hey, Sigzone. Thank you, thank you. And hey, Large Bear. Sweet.